Today, we will see about persistent volume and persistent volume claim, okay? Which is going to be part of your storage. And then we will talk about security in cluster, where we will see user accounts, and then, you know, service accounts. We will see how to, you know, use these accounts to, you know, control the actions that are happening inside our cluster. And then we will see roles and role binding. Okay. Finally, we will talk about networking. Okay. So by default, you know, Kubernetes does not provide any networking solution. Instead, it only defines how networking should be done. If you remember, when we created the cluster, we selected an option called as Calico, right?
Calico, yeah.
Yeah. So that is going to be the plugin that we are going to use for implementing networking in Kubernetes. Whatever, you know, Kubernetes, you know, suggests for networking, they actually test with this plugin. So that is why this is the one which is most commonly. So we are going to see how we can, you know, control communication between two containers. Okay. So these are the topics that we are going to cover today. So I'll remove this one. Okay. Let's start with persistent volume. We'll remove this also. We will anyway see this. Right. To talk about persistent volume, let's see one example. Adnan, are you using, you know, any form of cloud storage for your personal use? Like, you know, Google Drive or, you know, iCloud, any form of cloud storage?
Yeah, maybe in the iPhone.
iPhone. You would have used iCloud, right?
iCloud.
Yes. Why we go for iCloud?
Because you can access your data anywhere,
anytime, right? And not only that, you can also, you know, restore your data into a new device whenever, you know, you are switching devices, right? Say you have a, you know, older iPhone and you want to buy a newer iPhone. It will be very easy to restore our data from the cloud, right? Once we provide, yeah. So that is why, you know, we go for this persistent volume. Okay. So it does not, you know, depend on what type of device you are using. It will always be available for ever. Right. So apart, you know, from this iCloud, we have, you know, storage provided by Azure, Amazon, Google. So they also, you know, provide a storage accounts where you can, you know, create your storage similar to iCloud and push your data. Even in your organization, there might be some form of cloud storage, right? If I'm not wrong.
Maybe.
Yeah. If you have come across Azure, then definitely there will be cloud storage in your organization. For example, I'm telling you, okay? It need not be Azure always. It can be specific to some organization also. Your organization also might have your own, you know, private cloud storage. That also works, okay? So we are going to create this persistent volume in our cluster, okay? And we have two types of persistent volumes based on how we provision it. Static, dynamic, okay? Static is pre-configured, okay? Already you have a storage block available, let's say for 5 gigabytes or 10 gigabytes, then you know you are going to request it, right? In dynamic, you will request for, you know, storage. Let's say in iCloud or Azure or, you know, Amazon or Google, okay? You will request for storage and then only it will be, you know, given to you. Okay. We are going to do the static one, okay? Whenever, you know, you have a storage account, you can either read data or you can write data into it, right? Into your iCloud, yes? Correct, Adnan? You can read data and also you can write data, right? Here, we have three modes, Adnan, depending on the read and write operation and also the number of nodes who are accessing. Read write once, read write many. Here only one node can read write. Right? It can be any one node in your cluster. Only one node can do the read write operation. All nodes can do read write operation. Okay. All nodes can do only read operation. Okay. No node will be able to write anything into it, only read operation. Okay. So these are the three access modes. And in this, we prefer read write many, right? As we will, you know, run multiple pods in multiple nodes, it is better to have read write many, right? Yes. Yes. So these are the features of your persistent volume. So shall we create one persistent volume?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Okay. Now. I'm simply giving it as PV, okay? Persistent volume. No. Yeah, before we do this, let me show you the API version. Okay. API version is V1. Kind is persistent volume. Okay.
Yes.
API version V1. Kind persistent volume. Okay. Metadata, we can give some name for our persistent volume. Let's say PV1. Okay. And then inspect, we will mention the details. Now, for any cloud, online cloud storage that you create, size will be provided to you, right? It can be 5 GB or 20 GB or 50 GB, right? Right. So that we need to provide under capacity. Got it? Colon. Storage, let's say 2 gigabytes, right? And then whenever you attach any storage, you need some path, right, to access it. In our machine, we have C drive, D drive, right? That path, yes? In your laptop, you might have C drive, D drive, or any other drive name, right? In order to access your storage, yes? Path is going to be host path, okay? Say my vault data. So these are the four things you need to mention.
Okay,
done. Now, and save this kubectl create minus f pv.yml. Okay, kubectl describe pv pvman. So here you will get it, okay? Bare host directory vault. Okay. Capacity 2 GB. Access mode read, write, execute. Okay. Let me go to the whiteboard, okay? Now, this is your host, right? I will add some shapes for you, okay? Okay. So this is going to be your persistent volume, right? I'm putting it as PV. Now, from this persistent volume, if any, you know, pod or any container wants storage, we need to create a PVC, persistent volume client. I'm copying this. Okay. This is how it goes. Okay. And then. Okay, I'm giving different colors for the pods. Okay. Now, here you have your pods. Okay. Now, any number of pods can be attached to a PVC. Okay, any number of pods can, you know, request for storage from PVC, right? No, but one PVC can be attached to only one PV at a time. Okay, and this PV will be part of your host. Okay. This is how the relationship is, Adnan. Your host machine will have some storage, okay? From that, you are creating a persistent volume. You can create as many persistent volumes as you want, and each persistent volume will be mapped to only one persistent volume claim at a time, okay? And one persistent volume claim can, you know, be accessed by any number of pods, okay? Let me know if you have any queries in this relationship.
PVC stand for persistent volume.
Claim. CLAIM. Claim.
Okay.
I will write it down. PV claim. Okay. Persistent volume claim. Okay.
All right.
PV persistent volume, which is what we created right now. Okay.
All right. Good.
All good.
But yes.
Okay. Now, shall we do the persistent volume claim?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Again, you go to the cluster. Now, kubectl. I'm showing you the API version and time. Okay.
PBC.
Yeah, PBC. You can use short name also. It will work. API version V1, kind, persistent volume, claim. Okay. With pbc.claim. API version V1, kind, persistent, volume, claim. Metadata, term name. We can give pbc1 and then spec.
Okay.
Okay. No. Under spec, you are saying the properties that you expect. Okay. Storage class name. I expect host. Okay. Mm-hmm. Access modes. I expect read, write, mini. Okay. And then, how much storage do I expect? That I will put under resources. Request. Storage. I expect 1 gigabyte. Okay. So if there is a persistent volume with the class host, read, write, mini, and a storage of 1 gigabyte, your persistent volume claim will be created. Otherwise, it will not be created. This is the outcome of this file, right? Kubernetes will automatically find it for you. So we don't need to, you know, manually mention the persistent volume name. As per our illustration, host machine is there, PV is there, PVC is also there. Yes, no. Only thing we need to do is create pods which will access this PVC. Yes. Pod creation concept is the same. The only additional thing we are going to add is the details of the PVC in our file. Okay. I'm giving the name as pod PVC. Okay. API version, V1, kind, pod, metadata, name, pod, PVC. Okay.
Okay, done.
Now, under spec, we mentioned the details of the containers. Yes. Name, the container one, and then image. When we did MTDIR, we mentioned the mount path, right? all your mounts. Name, thumb name, and the mount path. So inside your container, there will be this directory where you can put all the files you want to. Okay. This is the first part. Please type this, and then we will do the second part. If you observe my screen, okay, I am trying to set the properties for the Vim editor. Okay. So this is the hidden file, .vimrc. Please type this. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now we are inside, right? Now, you might see some settings already enabled, right? Or you might see the file empty, yes? Right now, you type this line, okay? Set cursor column. Now what will happen is the column will get highlighted. That's it. This will help you to, you know, identify the indentation easily, right? Yes. Set space cursor, cursorcollumn.
Okay, done.
Done. Now you save the file. Now try to open that pod PVC file. You see column getting highlighted, right?
Yes, right.
Now it will be easier for you to check indentation, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep,
yes. I wanted you to, you know, get used to some playbooks. Only after that, I was about to tell you this. Since you got error again, now I felt it would be a good time for you to see this. Okay. This is only once. Okay. If you set it once, you are done. Okay. For any file that you edit, this will work. Okay. Now you can save this file. Okay. And create your pod. Pod is created, right? Now. Yes. Now. Yes. What we will do is we will go inside the pod and create some files. Okay. And then we will delete the pod. Since it is a persistent volume, whatever data we had created will be available in some node. Okay. Now, kubectl get pods minus o y. You run this command first and check in which node your pod got created. Okay. This is the last step we are going to do. Even if we delete some file in our phone, the file can be recovered from the cloud. That is what we are going to check now. Pod IP, node name. I hope you are getting the similar detail. It can be any node name.
Yeah, yes.
Yes, now. In this node only, the data will be available. Okay. Okay, now kubectl exec minus it pod name minus minus. No issues. Yes. the entry command is different, okay? You run this command. So now we are, now you will be inside the root directory. That is where you will see slash, okay? Do you see this container data directory?
Yeah.
In yours also, you will see a similar directory, yes? Whatever you had mentioned in the script, yes?
Yes.
We will go inside this and create some files.